Hello everybody, today we are going to see some more problems which are depend on the concept ASA condition, okay, angle side angle. Okay, we have seen theorem how to prove that, how to prove with the help of ASA condition or ASA congruency criteria. Okay, so see here, problem is given in figure AC is equal to BC, angle BCA is equal to angle ECB. Angle EBC is equal to angle EAC. Prove that triangles DBC and EAC are congruent and hence DC is equal to EC and BD is equal to AE. Okay, so this is given question and figure is also given. Okay, so once again I am reading here and we will see what they are asking and what is given. So first, what is given? AC is equal to BC. AC and BC are equal. This is AC. Are equal. Okay. Angle DCA is equal to ECB. DCA is equal to ECB. Means this angle is equal. This angle and this angle is equal. And then what is given? Angle DBC. DBC is this angle. Angle DBC is equal to angle EAC. EAC. Okay, means this. Now, what they are asking, see, prove that triangles DBC, DBC means DBC are DBC and EAC, EAC are congruent. Okay, we have to prove this given two angles are congruent. Okay, so if we are going to use ASA criteria, we must have two angles and one included side. Okay, two angles and included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding triangle. Two angles and one side. Okay. So here first we will think whether it is available or we need to do something different. Different way we need to do that we need sequence. Okay. So what is given? See, which two triangles they are asking? DBC and EAC. DBC. DBC. This triangle. Okay. So in DBC, this if I thinking about angle C, then both this angle is going to come. This whole angle is going to come. Okay. And EAC. Second is EAC. In that also, this whole angle is going to be. Understood? So now, angle C is common. These two angles are equal. Means ECB and DCA are equal. Okay, what is given? ECB and DCA. These two angles are equal. So I am taking that. Angle DCA is equal to angle ECB. This is given. Two angles are equal. Suppose we will add this part, this is common part of angle C. This part we will add in both the sides, in this angle also and this angle also. Then two measurement of both the angles will remain same. Okay, this if I will add this here in this angle and that angle. Okay, so which angle I am going to add? DCE in both the sides. Okay, so angle DCA plus this angle was given. And I am adding this angle in that. That is DCE angle DCE is equal to angle ECB plus ECB this angle plus this angle. So the same I am adding this angle DCE. DCE. Okay. Same angle we have added in LHS and RHS in both the sides. So the value of both the angles. So both the angles are going to remain same. Understood? So now see here, DCA plus AC. DCA plus DCE is what? We will get this whole angle. Okay? So can I say here ECA angle ECA or ACE? This, the sum of these two is angle ACE. ACE is equal to ECE plus DCE. ECB is this angle plus this angle. So what we will get? The sum of these two. Sum of these two will be what we will get? Angle DCB. Angle DCB. Okay. Angle DCB. Okay. So this is one thing we have. Okay. So now I can say, if I will take this, I can see here this angle. This angle and this angle is equal of both the triangles. Okay. Now second thing they have told us AC is equal to CB, and this angle is already given equal. So we have three things according to this criteria. We have two angles and one side. So we can use now. I am taking these two triangles. So in triangle DBC and triangle EAC, triangle DBC and triangle EAC, we can say this is this. I am saying here first one. So angle ACE is equal to angle DCB from first. Okay, here we have given all the reasons. Okay, so here we can say from one. Second thing, we can say AC is equal to BC. AC is equal to BC. Why? This is given. Given in the question. Third thing, we can say EAC is equal to DBC. Okay? EAC angle. EAC is equal to EAC is equal to DBC angle. DBC. This is also given. Okay. So now we have two angles and one included side. Two angles and included side. So we can say triangle DBC component triangle DBC component triangle EAC by ASA by ASA triangle. Okay. So here we have given the two. Both the triangles are congruent. Now they are asking, see, are congruent and hence DC is equal to BC. Okay, DC is equal to BC and BD, where is BD? BD is equal to AE. Okay, these are the two sides. These are the sides of congruent triangle. These are the sides of congruent. So here not necessary to write anything else. So with the help of CPCT we can say DC is equal to BC and BD is equal to A. Okay, so for both we can write CP, CD, corresponding parts of congruent. If triangles are congruent, all the sides, meaning all the sides, corresponding sides are congruent. Corresponding angles are also congruent. So here for this only CP, CD we can write. What is important here? We have to put here triangles are congruent. Okay, with the proper criteria. Okay. Okay, so our second problem is in figure it is given that RT is equal to TS. RT is equal to TS. Angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2 and angle 4 is equal to 2 times angle 3. Prove that triangle RBT congruent triangle SA. Okay, so now see here, once again you will see what is given. Okay. RT is equal to TS. RT and TS is given. This RT and TS are equal. Okay, so that is one thing given. So one thing we will understand that triangle TRS is an isosceles triangle. Triangle TRS is an isosceles triangle because these two sides are equal. So definitely base angles are equal. Base angles are equal. So we can see here this angle, angle R and angle S. Angle R and angle S are equal. Okay, so from this we can understand this. What it will be? Second thing, what is given? Angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2. This angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2. This whatever measurement of angle 2 is there, that will be the 2 times of angle 1. As same as here, angle 4 is equal to angle 2 times of angle 3. 2 times of angle 2. Okay. One thing we will come to know, that is angle 1 and angle 4 are vertically opposite angles and vertically opposite angles are always equal. So angle 1 and angle 4 are equal. Okay. So these things we are going to use in the proof. Okay. So whenever these things are given, that time we have to think about the figure, what is given and how to use that in the proof, that we need to think properly. Then only we can get proper proof. Okay. So now prove that triangle RBT, congruent triangle SAT, this triangle, RBT and SAT, these two triangles we have to prove congruent. Okay. So if I am going to use any congruency criteria, what is given here, see, RT and TS are equal, RT and TS are equal. This is common angle for both the triangles, that is we can say RTS or RTB, okay, component STA, okay, that is common angle, so it will be definitely same, so we can give common reason. So we have this side, this angle, okay. Now if I am going to use ASA criteria, if we are going to use ASA criteria, so we have angle, side. Now we need to think about this. Now we need to think about this. This angle, that is angle TRB and angle TSA. This angle. Okay, we need to show both the triangles, both the angles are common. Okay, so we can use their ASA criteria. Okay, so two things we have, that is TR is equals to TS, which is given. Angle T is the common angle for both the triangles, which they are asking here. Okay, and we need to prove that angle, this angle is equals to, that is TRB is equals to TSA. If we will prove this, then we can show by ASA criteria both the triangles are common. Okay, so first we will think about this, because this is not given directly. We need to show that both the angles are concrete. Okay, so how to show that carefully? As we know that TRS is equals to TSR. Okay, firstly, angle TRS is equals to angle TSR. R and S. TRS is equals to TSR. Why? Because angles opposite of equal sides are same. So we can see here RT is equals to TS. RT is equals to TS, which is given. Okay. RT and TS are equal. So angles opposite of equal sides are same. So angle R and angle S are equal. Okay. Now what we can say, what is given, see, angle 1 is equals to angle 4. Angle 1 is equals to angle 4. Why? Vertically opposite. Vertically opposite angle. Angle 1 and angle 4 are equal because vertically opposite angle. Okay. One thing they have told us, angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2. And angle 4 is equal to 2 times angle 3. Okay. Which is given. These two things are given in the question. Okay. Angle 1 is equal to 2 times angle 2. Angle 4 is equal to 2 times angle 3. But angle 1 and angle 4 are equal. Angle 1 and angle 4 are equal by vertically opposite angles. So if this is equal, angle 1 and angle 4 are equal, definitely its RHS are equal. So we can see here 2 times angle 2 is equal to 2 times angle 3. So we can cancel this 2. So angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 3. So this angle, this angle and this angle is equal, angle 2 and angle 3 is equal, but still we have to prove here TRS, we are thinking about this and we got now this, okay, these two angles are equal. So one thing can be to here, TRS minus angle 2, okay, and TSR minus angle 3, we are subtracting because here it is given. This is, we will say this is first one, okay, so and this is, we will say second one, okay. So we can say now here, I am saying here from subtract second from 1, second from 1, okay, this we will subtract from this, okay, so that I am taking here now. What I am saying here, TRS angle, TRS minus angle 2 is equal to angle TSR, angle TSR minus angle 3, okay. This is equal, this is first one, okay, and we have subtracted from both the sides angle 2 and 3, we have subtracted the same value from both the sides, so its value is going to remain constant. We are not going to change this basic value. Okay, it is going to remain same. So now TRS minus angle 2 and TSR minus angle 3. Okay. So this we can say. So now here TRS minus 2 if from angle TRS we will subtract angle 2, what is going to remain? TRB. Okay, angle TRB is equals to, and from this TSR we will subtract angle 3, then what is going to remain? TSA, angle TSA. Okay, so this we got. Now we will say here second. Okay, after subtraction we got this. Now we will think about triangle RBT. Now in triangle RBT and triangle SAT. Okay, RBT. In triangle RBT, what we can say? That is, this is given. First one we will take this TRB is equal to angle TSA. This is from second. Okay, this first thing we got. Then RT is equal to ST. RT is equal to ST, which is given. And then we can say RTB, angle RTB is equal to STA, angle STA. Okay, because common angle. Common. This is common angle. So by ASA, by angle side triangle, we can say triangle RBT congruent triangle SAT by ASA, angle side angle congruent square. Okay, so this was not given directly, so this way we need to use some previous things which are given, and with the help of this, first we have to show that is which is not given, and then we can use in the congruence. What did you do? Okay, see here also, next problem is two lines AB and CD intersect at O such that BC is equal and parallel to AD. Prove that the lines AB and CD bisect at O. Okay, once again see carefully. Two lines AB and CD intersect at O. AB and CD intersect at O. This is point O. Such that BC is equal and parallel to AD. BC, this BC is equal to AD and parallel also. Okay, two things are there. BC and AD are equal and parallel. Okay. Now, after that, what is given? Prove that the lines AB and CD bisect at O. AB and CD bisect at O. This, when both lines are bisecting at O, so we have to prove that OB and OA are equal and OC and OD are equal. Okay, this piece we have to prove. Okay, so here it is sufficient to prove that both the triangles are congruent. Okay, if we are able to prove triangles OCB and triangle ODA are congruent, then automatically we can say this, what is they are asking, AB and CD bisect at O, then we can say OC is equals to OD and OB is equals to OA by CPC. Okay, so here first we need to prove that triangle, this triangle OBC and triangle OAD are congruent. Okay, so I am taking that here in triangle COB and triangle DOA, triangle DOA. What is given? CB is equals to AD. CB is equals to AD. What is the reason? This is given. Okay, so the reason we need to write given. Now see, if these two lines are parallel also, CB and AD are parallel to each other. Okay, when lines are parallel and it cut by a transversal, that time we can say by alternate interior angles are equal. So here we can say, if these two lines are parallel and CD is a transversal, that time we can say angle C is equal to angle D. Angle C is equal to angle D. Okay. Then angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A is equal to angle B. Okay. Because here we can say this angle COB and angle DOB, DOA are also equal by vertically opposite angle, but we cannot use that angle because we need, if we are going to use ASA criteria, we are going to use AAC criteria. The side and two angles and included side should be equal to the two angles and included side of the another triangle. Then only we can use that criteria. Okay, so for that we can show here this result. Okay, so I am saying here OCB angle OCB is equals to OCB is equals to ODA angle ODA. Okay, then second thing OBC angle OBC is equals to OAD angle OAD. What is the reason? Here it is given AD BC is equals to BC is equal and parallel to AD. BC is parallel to AD. Okay, and AB CD are transversal. AB and CD are transversal. Okay, so with the help of this we can say, so here what is there, see angles and included side, two angles and included side we have, so we can say triangle COB complement triangle DOA by side angle side by ASA by ASA congruency criteria. Okay, now we have given here two, these two triangles are congruent. So now we can say OC is equals to OD as well as OA is equals to OB. Why? By CPC, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, if these are equal, so we can say O, due to O, both the lines are bisect. What they are asking, prove that the lines AB and CD bisect at O. Bisect is what? This part and this part is equal, this and this is equal. So here we have given proof. So here directly we can say, so the lines AB and CD. So lines AB and CD bisect at O. Okay? Got it, everybody? Thank you.